going on, everybody? It's Coach Tyler. I am back in action, and today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. So with these channels, I started this channel, fitness channel, mainly to talk about, you know, fitness, nutrition, motivation, all these kind of things. But over time, I was like, you know what, you gotta keep things fresh. So then I started the cooking series. I love the cooking series. I'm gonna start doing more recipes. I've been out of commission a little bit. Decided to do a bodybuilding competition. That was awesome. I'm gonna probably do a series about that and my experience with that as just like a regular person that just decided to jump into, you know, competing on stage. But another thing that I like sports. And one particular thing I enjoy watching is mixed martial arts. I've been a fan for quite some time. I love watching it. I train with a former UFC fighter, try to stay in shape, keep you know, the lungs nice and fresh so you don't start gasping after walking up the steps. You know, small stuff like that. But that's neither here nor there. I love watching sport. It's fun. It's crazy to see how it's evolved and how it's changed so quickly in such a short amount of time from the era of dudes fighting with one boxing glove on, one off, to, you know, some sort of strategy, you know, where you had Royce Gracie choking out everybody, now to a dude like Habib, who just is a complete anomaly to the sport. He runs through people with almost without like any real danger. So it's really incredible to have watched it, and especially going from VHS tapes to watching it on Spike TV and FX, and now it's on ESPN. Like, kudos to whoever made those moves, because that's absolutely incredible. But anyway, I love MMA and I've been watching it for a while, and I figured, you know, why not make, I guess I could call this MMA Hour with Coach Tyler. So that sounds fun. Make a little series, talk about upcoming fights, fighters, that kind of stuff. We'll see where it goes, but I think I'll take a crack at it and, you know, maybe have some other friends of mine who love the stuff talk about it and have, you know, neutral stances. I'm not a particular fan of any fighter, but I just enjoy the sport in general. So, you know, and this week, you know, starting this week at, I think it's, oh yeah, this coming Saturday, we have a fight between Khabib Nurmagomedov and Justin Gaethje. These two guys, I mean, these two guys are both, they're beasts. Like, it's just, let's actually, you know what, let's start with Khabib. Khabib is a very, very, like, he's a relentless, tough, the guy seems to not get tired, and when he gets on you, he's like a metal blanket. Like, you just can't do anything. I don't think anyone's been able to just successfully just stand up and walk away from any of his takedowns. Like, some people have gotten up, of course, but most of the time when he gets you down, you stay down. He wraps up your legs, he uses his legs like arms, he takes your arms and grabs your arms from underneath you, puts them behind you, doing all this while he's punching you in the face and basically sapping you of your strength, your energy, and your spirit. You see the eyes of some of these guys while they're fighting him, and he's just there and just mauling them to death. And it just looks like, hey, you know what? They're like, I'm getting paid for this, so let's just get this over with and get me out of here. and I could understand, because getting taken down and not being able to get out of guck is an absolutely horrible feeling. If you've never experienced it, it's something you probably never want to experience and you probably never want to, and hopefully you don't. But it's absolutely demoralizing, and it's something that, you know, it's crazy to see people at that level, especially since everyone is able to wrestle to some degree, just completely dominated and smashed. And that dude's very good at that. I can't think back to any fights where he was in any real trouble, like any danger. He's been touched up before. Michael Johnson touched him. I wouldn't say he was in any real danger there, but he did get touched, took him down, did what he does. Barboza landed some leg kicks, I believe. He landed some pretty good inside leg kicks. Took him down. That was the end of that. You know, it's never been in, like, he's been any real kind of war like Gaethje. Gaethje fights in wars. Like, it's insane that guy, you know, comes in with this, like, anime-type approach to fights where he's just, like, you know, massive punch after massive punch after massive punch. He eats a nasty punch. He throws a leg kick. You eat a punch. Throws another leg kick. And it just seems to never end until someone's, you know, lying on the canvas snoring. So it's really entertaining to watch. But on Khabib again, the guy's relentless. He's very good at what he does. And he kind of reminds me of the early days of the UFC with Royce Gracie, where people kind of had an idea what was going on, but they just they just couldn't stop it. Like, they were like, this guy's really good when he takes you down and he's going to choke you out. But, you know, people would get in there and they're like, yeah, you know what? Not too worried about it. I'm bigger. I'm stronger. It didn't really matter. He did what he did to those people, choked him out. It was the end of the story. Seems to be the same thing with Khabib. People know what's coming. You know, they probably know what it is now. And it just doesn't matter. He still just does what he does, gets in there, gets out of there unscathed. I don't know if the guy's ever even bled in the octagon, which is amazing considering the sport that you're in, where you got elbows, knees, accidental headbutts, all kinds of crazy stuff that happen. You can slip and fall in there and bust your head open. It's weird. But let's get to Justin Gaethje now. They gave that dude the perfect nickname, the human highlight reel. That's for sure. The guy does a backflip off the cage just for fun. I'd probably break both my legs trying to do something like that. It's incredible to watch. Just that after he's already been done fighting for however many rounds, you know, with these tiny little gloves, leg kicks, elbows, and all that stuff. But yeah, Justin Gaethje came in. I believe he was undefeated when he came in. He was a champion in a previous organization. Comes in, fights a classic fight with Michael Johnson. It was amazing. That was a great fight. I think Michael Johnson had a chance to actually win that early on. Didn't capitalize, got put down. It happens. Dude continues to fight some of the best in the organization. He takes two L's, you know, from, what was it? I think it was Eddie Alvarez and Poirier. You know, these guys, you know, they're legends in their own right. Poirier is like the mini, Khabib is anointed. Poirier is like the mini boss to the boss in like Street Fighter. He's like Vega or Sagat to M. Bison at this point in the UFC. He says if you get through him, you get a title shot. And I think that's pretty that's pretty respectful and pretty relevant considering how dominant Khabib is. And all the people that he's fought, he hasn't said anything about that about anyone else but Dustin Poirier. Poirier put up a good fight against him, but at the end of the day, Khabib does what he does. But anyway, back to Justin Gaethje. He took these guys on, Eddie Alvarez. You know, he won the most violent man title. Didn't get it, but it was one heck of a fight. He went in there, rock 'em, sock 'em, robot style. Same thing with Poirier. Took the L. Guy comes back completely, seems to completely overhaul his approach to fighting. Like, kudos to him for being able to flip the switch. Because a lot of these guys, when they fight, that's who they are. It's not often that you see somebody completely 180 their strategies when they're fighting. Because who said that? Mike Tyson said it best. Everyone has a plan until they get punched in the face. You see a lot with these guys. The minute they get hit hard, they go back immediately to whatever it is they normally do, whether it's they go in for a shot or they start swinging like psychopaths. This guy seems to be able to really just hone in on his game plan, follow the game plan, and get the job done. What I think is unique about him as far as being a threat to Khabib in any sense is that this dude hits really hard. I mean, all these guys at this level hit hard, but he seems to hit devastatingly hard. Like, he put down Tony Ferguson, who had not lost in years. Like, and that guy fought some of the best that the UFC had to offer at the time. And he ran through him, and he almost made it look easy, aside from the time he got sat down from an uppercut. But, you know, things happened, he survived. Life goes on. But he comes in, he hits hard, and another little thing about him is his leg kicks. He has these nasty leg kicks that they're almost like an inside hook with a punch, but they're kicks. so when you come in with a hook with a punch, that's basically what he's doing with a leg kick, and it's a very whipping, nasty, powerful leg kick, and he lands a couple of those things on you and the entire fight has changed. You saw that in the two fights he lost. He landed those kicks on Alvarez and Poirier. He may have lost because he didn't revert to a better strategy rather than leading in with his head, trying to, you know, Goku his way through through the win, but didn't work out that way. And not at that level. These guys are too good. They're too sturdy, and they're too precise to have that approach to guys in like the top 10. He found that out. He revamped his strategy, and now the guy is an assassin. Like, I can't see anyone really beating him right now. And you know, there's always this thing, well, he's just going to get taken down. He's going to get mauled like everyone else that Khabib has fought. Is it possible? Sure, it's possible. But no one's really seen Justin Gaethje wrestle. And according to people in the news media and the UFC fighters and analysts, they say this guy is a stud wrestler. Khabib has fought wrestlers before. Not necessarily studs. Maybe Gaethje's a step above these guys. No one really knows because no one's ever really seen him wrestle in any of his fights. I think he might have gotten taken down once by accident by like Eddie Alvarez, maybe Alvarez or Poirier, I can't remember which one, but no one's really, you know, seen his grappling skills in the octagon. I'm sure he has them. All those people do. It's just about, like, is he able to utilize that to keep Khabib from taking him down the ground and punching his face in. Seems like most people have been unable to do that as of yet, but who knows? If he's able to do that, I can see him winning the fight. As long as he can stuff some takedowns, if he lands, I would say, three or four of those leg kicks, the whole fight's changed. You know, Khabib might have to fight southpaw for the rest of the fight. You never know what could happen. MMA, it's hard to make predictions in this sport. The guy can be winning the entire fight and then make one wrong move and gets kicked in the face and the fight is over. I think it could go either way. Everyone's super, you know, a lot of them are on the Khabib train. I'm never riding the train of anybody in this sport because you never know what might happen. We've seen some huge upsets. I mean, if you've been a fan of the sport for a while, you'll remember a guy by the name of George St. Pierre. George St. Pierre got KO'd by Matt Serra, who in his own right, great fighter, but he was severely undersized for that division. He landed a heavy right hand on GSP and put him to sleep, took the title, and walked away. And this guy, GSP, was like one of the most dominant, probably had one of the highest fight IQs the sport had ever seen. Didn't wrestle in high school, didn't wrestle in college, became one of the most dominant wrestlers in the UFC. Made no sense, but that's just how good that guy was. But he got slept by a guy that was much smaller than him, and no one saw that coming. If you put $1,000 on there, you probably made like $1 million. But crazy things have happened in the sport. You know, anything can happen. But if I would put my money on anyone, I always like the underdog. Justin Gaethje's the underdog. I'd say if he can stuff some takedowns and he can keep up his relentless high-pressure pace, land some of those nasty inside leg kicks and those crazy hooks that he lands that have the devastating power. He's got some of the best hooks I've seen in mixed martial arts. And if he can land some of those things and make Khabib bleed, something that I don't think anyone's done, you know, if he can drag him into those waters and take him into hell that he does with everyone else, Justin Gaethje brings people to hell in his fights. I mean, Khabib kind of does the same thing, but it's not nearly as violent as what Gaethje does. He brings you to hell, and I'm curious to see how Khabib reacts when he's brought to hell with somebody where he's bleeding all over the place, he's severely compromised, maybe his legs out giving out. I'm really curious to see, because we've seen how Gaethje reacts. He keeps coming forward, and he does his thing, and unless you have him with it, you know, have him flayed out flat on the ground with his toes curled, looking to the stars, he's going to keep coming at you with everything he's got. So I'm really excited to see this fight. You know, leave comments, and I might do a couple more videos about these in the future. We'll see how this goes, but I really enjoy talking about this. It's a subject I really enjoy, and yeah, like, comment, subscribe, and, you know, Coach Tyler will be seeing you guys soon, so have a good one, and peace.